I had a very interesting conversation with my English editor. He had a meeting with my French editor at the Book Fair in London, and she explained to him that I had a very strong readership in Quebec, in French-speaking Canada. And she suggested to my English editor that it might be a nice acknowledgement, an homage, a thank you to my Quebecois readers if I would consider the possibility of writing a book in Canada. And I said, of course, you know, I'm happy to do that. Just so you understand that I did not let the Canadians take priority over the French, I had already written a book, most of which takes place in Paris, but it has not yet been translated into French. Anyway, I began to research Canada. I'd been to Quebec and I'd been to the north several times. And when I'm researching an area, I always try and find something unusual or try and find something interesting about the environment. And I discovered that in the 1950s, the iron ore, the Iron Mining Company of Canada, built cities for their workers, for the miners, in the very, very northeast of Quebec, where it's brutal, brutal, desolate, terrible environment, where the sun doesn't rise for many months of the year. And then in the summer, the sun never sets, and it's humid, and there's mosquitoes, and it's just a very, very unpleasant environment to live. And it takes a long time to get there. And once you're there, it's very difficult to leave. And this seemed to me like a very intriguing idea to set a polar, because you have the claustrophobia of the environment. You have the tension where everything in nature is a challenge for you. And when something occurs within this community, people look inwards because there cannot be anything outside. And the more I understood of this environment and the more I understood of these cities that were built, the more it seemed like an ideal location for a novel. That really was the catalyst, the original motivation for writing the book. And I wanted to make the environment feel like another character, another person. So when you think about the book, you don't only think about the story, you don't only think about the people, but you also think about the environment and the way in which it affected people's attitudes and people's lives. Did it change the way that I wrote? I think because I write books that are so different and there is no series character, and because I choose a different location and I choose a different time period for every book, I think naturally my approach changes with each new endeavor, with each new venture. But this was particularly interesting to me. And I think its strongest elements are its ambiance, its atmosphere, in the same sort of vein as Sur le Silence, but obviously a very, very different novel. I, you know, when we talk about why people write, and when we talk about what people write about, I think it's inevitable that there's going to be elements of autobiography and personal experience in their writing. Often when I'm writing a character, I will place myself in that character and think, if this was me, what would I do? How would I feel? What decisions would I make? So I think because of the style of story that I write, which is very focused on the characters, what they think, what they feel, what they decide, how they deal with the consequences of those decisions, I think I am always personally involved in it. And because I write books in a very, very short period of time, 8 weeks or 10 weeks from start to finish, and I'm working on it very intensively every day for 6 or 8 hours, it's almost like I'm living in that environment as well. So I become part of the story. Inevitably, I become part of the story. I'm very invested in it. But I devote myself in the same way to each novel, regardless of the subject matter or regardless of the environment. There is a bande dessinée in process for Vendetta. There is also a film adaptation of Un Cœur Sombre, A Dark and Broken Heart. I didn't write the screenplay, it was written by a screenplay writer, and that is a film that is being produced by a Canadian film company. I've also written the first two or three episodes of a planned 12-episode adaptation of Vendetta. But I've also written two television series and two film that are not adaptations of books. They are original stories, which I'm currently in, we're casting them. I'm producing them. I'm working with other producers and actors to get them made. I'm very interested in film and television. I think the way that I write is probably more influenced by cinema than it is by literature. Because when I'm writing, I think cinematographically. I think in pictures, I think in images. So it is something that is very interesting to me and something I wish to continue to explore in the years to come. I think the fundamental problem with my books when it comes to adaptation is they're long, they're complex, they usually occur across two different time periods. As soon as you set a book in the past, when you start to look at it from the viewpoint of film, it costs two times as much money immediately when it's not a contemporary story. So I think that is a challenge for filmmakers. So my solution for that is to write original material as opposed to trying to adapt things from books. I, as a child, always felt that I wanted to do something artistic and creative with my life, but I had no idea what it was. Believe it or not, I studied ballet for 8 years. I played the trumpet with orchestras. I studied graphic art and design. I studied photography. I was always reading in many different genres and also in nonfiction. I was always very, very interested in film. But in November of 1987, I had a conversation with a stranger about a book that they were reading. The book was It by Stephen King. And he spoke about it with such passion and such enthusiasm, and it was like a light went on in my head. And I thought, that would be a wonderful thing to do with your life, to have the ability to captivate a reader, to enchant a reader, to emotionally engage a reader with a story that you told. And so that same evening, it was November the 4th, 1987, I started writing my first book, and over the next 6 years, I wrote 24 novels and didn't get any of them published. But that's a different story. But it was that conversation, a simple conversation with a stranger, that acted as a catalyst to inspire me to do this with my life. And once I decided that that was what I wanted to do with my life, I didn't have a plan B. I didn't have any other solution of what I was going to do. And I'm very, very fortunate that after many, many years and many, many books, I did find a publishing house in England that were willing to publish my first book. And I've published one every year since.